In the last video, I covered the LBV, LBV88, enhanced LBV, and so forth as a comprehensive context for what the next system is. The next system we're going to cover is what's referred to as the Safariland SPEAR LBV. The ECLS, ELCS, the SPEAR is a whole system, not just the vest. But the vest is what stands out the most, and everyone refers to the vest colloquially as the Safariland SPEAR. So SPEAR is an acronym. It stands for Special Operations Forces Personal Equipment Advanced Requirements. Special Operations Forces in that is all just the S. And they had to do that horrifically lopsided abbreviation to make the acronym cool, because they want to call it the SPEAR. You're going to see a lot of ugly acronyms like that. So once more, the vest is just the Equipment Load Carrying System, or ELCS. So this properly is the SPEAR ELCS vest. So the SPEAR system was requested specifically by US SOCOM, the United States Special Operations Command, with command being the CO and M at the end. So in the last one, you saw entire words missing from the acronym. With this one, they used one word for three letters of the acronym, because it sounds cool. They're not really supposed to make sense. You're just supposed to be already familiar with the subject when you hear the acronym. So the United States Army, Navy, and Air Force all colloquially refer to this as such, and it was requested by SOCOM on behalf of all three entities. All three of them at the time used the M81 woodland camouflage that everybody should be familiar with. When you think of camouflage, this is the camouflage most people think of. This was available in Type 1, 2, and 3. Type 1 is woodland. Type 2 is the day desert camo, otherwise known as the coffee stain by most people for DCU camo. And then type 3 is black. I'm not sure that it was ever actually produced. I have never seen a single piece of this system anywhere on the secondhand market in black. The only thing I can think of that comes close is Eagle Industries made sets of the standard MOLLE, and they made that in black for Afghanistan National Security Forces, which also were never used. So once more, the vest is just the ELCS equipment load carrying system for the whole SPEAR. This is meant to go over body armor, and it's meant specifically to go over the Ceradyne BALCS body armor load carrying system, if I recall. And it's meant to be adjusted at the back to fit the user with this cinched in all the way. And then when you wear this over armor, you simply quickly adjust it at the front to fit over the armor, so it can be sized to wear with and without. It looks very similar to the LBV, but it's a MOLLE compatible system, so it has the PALS webbing. So the webbing itself is the pouch attachment ladder system. So this is PALS, and then the overall system, the pouches and everything that attach to it, are MOLLE. Most people use those terms interchangeably, but that's the proper. Alright, now with all of the context as to why the vest, we're going to go with what the vest. So there's a back panel, a belt system, and then the front panels, and the PALS webbing for the MOLLE system is angled, just like the pouches on the enhanced LBV are angled slightly. So you can wear this a little bit higher up, you can cinch it up to have the rucksack's belt go under it and use it more like a chest rig than, say, an H-harness. And it makes those magazines a little bit easier to extract. Now, this will actually fit three magazine pouches wide, although I only recommend doing this, say, if you have something on the other side that is not magazines. This one's equipped to carry launcher ammunition on one side, rifle magazines on the other, and then a pistol magazine on this side as well. This is set up specifically as a loaner. I have a few of these, like my personal one here, is not set up to carry rifle magazines, and this one's set up to go with a rifle. So one of the features that I enjoy on the Spear is it has a flotation insert. Inside of this mesh backing here, there's a gray foam insert. It's a tan color on the desert model, and that makes this vest neutrally buoyant. It won't help the user to float, but it itself doesn't add weight. It's carrying its own weight, so it's not any harder for the end user. So the adjustment mechanism on these is pretty cool because you actually have a hardened tab that fits into the PALS webbing of the belt, and the chest harness or the load-bearing vest front panel actually slides on the belt and then hooks into the PALS webbing on the MOLLE belt to adjust it. Now this is the gross adjustment, and we'll say the fine adjustment is on the front. So you adjust it at the back where the two panels touch in the middle when you are not wearing body armor, and then you can expand the front, as I said earlier, to go with the body armor. I personally like to wear mine very open, where the pouches are down and low and on the sides, and then I have a pouch and a large patch on my body armor that shows through the front of this, and I can use some of that real estate for the modular webbing on the plate carrier right in the middle. Now, most people prefer to keep it closed and wear it up high like a chest rig. That's kind of the modern cool thing to do, but you can do almost anything with this. So another oddity you're going to see for the system is that they have their own special pouches. They're all meant to use the MOLLE and MOLLE 2 pouches, but you'll recognize one of the pouches right away because it will have the snap buttons inside of the material, so you don't see it on the outside. I'm imagining this is some kind of anti-reflective feature. Maybe they expect it to get, you know, scuffed, worn down, shiny, and they think that this will show through. Maybe it's just because it looks better. But it's under the material here. Say, for example, this magazine pouch looks just like a MOLLE magazine pouch, except the snap is hidden inside of the material here, and it has two drainage holes on the bottom. Functionally interchangeable, but they needed to justify doubling the price somehow. So my favorite one of these special pouches on here is the triple magazine pouch. It has a pouch for a strobe on this side, it has a pouch for a grenade on the front, and then it has a center compartment that fits three Stenag magazines, or say a larger grenade or a bulky square object. There's a left and right version of this pouch. So you have the grenade usually facing the front. You would put two of these on. These are meant for the H harness configuration, although I personally prefer the load-bearing vest because as an H harness, you don't have any of these nice features that it has with the angled MOLLE or the flotation. But some people might like it to be a little bit lighter and not weigh like 12 pounds like mine does with the belt pouches. So a great resource for finding all of these acronyms and instruction manuals is CIE Hub. And there's actually a page that depicts the ELCS setup with one H-harness panel on one side and one load-bearing vest panel on the other, making it asymmetrical. And that, I'm not sure why you would want that, but you can do anything to this vest, even if it's something ridiculous. It's very configurable, and that's why it's very expensive. Now, if you want to look at something on eBay, for example, if you find one of those triple magazine pouches that I love so much, just this is going to run $50. And that's kind of insane, but everything for the Spear has an insane price. And in my opinion, it's justified. But there's a few little things you could do here and there. And there's one great tip I have for maybe building something like this on the cheap. So this back panel here is held on by 1-inch webbing. It's all the same PAL system. It even still has the metal adjustments pieces from the ELCS and the LBV. You can use an LBV shoulder harness, and you can find these load-bearing vest panels by themselves or spare parts for the H-harness front. And you can take a Molly equipment belt or say a belt from an FLCS, use that belt, any aftermarket shoulder straps that fit this 1-inch webbing, and then the front panels alone, and kind of build yourself like a budget ELCS. Now, you won't get all this real estate on the back, and I just have my stack mags and some camouflage material on mine. I use something that fits flat under a rucksack, actually, but if you do want something like that, I actually used a spare piece of Smirsch on one of these that I had some spare parts for to make another one. Now, this will fit anything with the 1-inch webbing I mentioned earlier, and I do mean anything, because the Smirsch and the LBV and this are all based on the older United States Alice H-harness, or the LC2. So, all of these are compatible, even if they are not supposed to be.
So we're just going to take a quick look at my personal one here. This one is set up to support a belt-fed weapon. So I have two 200-round belt pouches, a 100-round belt pouch, and then this I'm really using more as a utility pouch, but I have my strobe, a grenade on the front, and then I have just grenade pouches up here, and then I have launcher grenade pouches up here with two specialized flashbang grenade pouches front and back so I don't get them mixed up with the other grenades. This one's set up as a loader for a rifle equipped with a launcher. It has all of the rifle equipped on one side, all of the launcher equipped on the other. The rifle pouches, if somebody is right-handed, fit here so their left hand accesses it. And then the ones you do not need to access as quickly are on the opposite side.
So that's anything and everything to know about the SPEAR system, its compatibility with other systems, intended or not, the Molly system, and that you can spot a pouch that has the snap button hidden inside the material and know it's instantly worth $40 more than a regular Molly pouch. Next time I'm going to cover the Molly medic vest or something bizarre that has pouches that maybe kind of look like this. It maybe kind of looks like an LBV-88 with PALS webbing on it. And I occasionally see them, or I find them at gun shows, or I see them listed online, and nobody knows what they are. So, I hope by the end of this, you'll understand or appreciate these systems, or maybe just save a few dollars here and there. So that's all I have for today.